All that is here is Ishvara, the Lord. That is something which I can understand. But you can ask, I understand all that is here is Ishvara. This is there in our culture. You go to a small person and he will, and if you ask him, hey, where is Ishvara? He will say, in everything there is Ishvara. So how does it really change my life? What does it do for me in terms of living my life more effectively? And this is the verse which answers that question. It's not just a cognitive, intellectual understanding and then your life continues to be the same. It has to fundamentally change in how you view things and how you incorporate this bigger picture in your day-to-day living. That is the essence of this verse. It says, मत कर्म कृत मत परमः मत भक्त संग वर्जितः निर्वैर सर्वभूतेषु यसमामेति पांडव. What is meant is understanding the fact that the Lord is in the form of dharma. So once I perform an action incorporating dharma or the ethics, I am the one who becomes the person who has awareness of Ishvara in form of dharma while performing the action. When I recognize that the results come from the order which is Ishvara, and that order is infallible in nature, in my life there is awareness of Ishvara. When I recognize that every desire, my capacity to desire is from Ishvara, it's not away from Ishvara, but if I begin to choose the desire with which I go along or I don't go along, depending upon what is it which is expected of me, my interlinkages, my interconnectedness with vast scheme of things, and seeing my role in that, I am in touch with Ishvara. These are all the things that I can learn. I am connected to Ishvara. I am not connected only when I am doing some bhajan or I am doing some prayer. The awareness of Ishvara, if I can bring in my life while choosing whether I should go along with my desires or not, whether I perform the action, what kind of actions I'm going to perform, what are the considerations that I'm going to take in my stride before I choose the action, then that is something where I'm in touch with Ishvara. My responses to the result, I'm in touch with Ishvara, appropriate responses. But that is not all. That is all the things that is acquired learning. There is this huge me, which is the unconscious me, depending upon my childhood experiences. What has happened to me? How my father or my mother has behaved with me? What kind of impressions it has left on me? The teacher, my interaction with the teachers, my interaction with the friends, they all leave some kind of scars or some kind of past deep impressions which continue to guide my behavior even today. Very often we have certain dislike for a certain person, or we carry some anger, or we carry fears. These are all not just based on what I see or what I understand now. They are coming from the unconscious. The modern psychology talks a lot about the unconscious and what is stored in you, and that continues to interfere with you and with your behaviors in spite of your recognizing what is appropriate and what is not appropriate. And this is where often you can see for yourself that what you understand when you come to Vedanta classes, when you are exposed to Gita, you understand everything what is being talked about. You understand what is the right behavior, what is an appropriate thing to do. But you go back and you sometimes fall into your past patterns, which are not always in keeping with what you understand to be more desirable. So it seems as though there are two parallel persons. One is the person who has acquired this wisdom, who understands many things, and the other one is the habitual behavior, the person with a certain programming which sometimes totally takes over, and there is at times struggle between the two. And which one takes over at any given point in time, it only depends. And this is why even when you look at some other people and you say, wow, they are spiritual, they are supposed to be studying Gita, but in spite of all of that, how is it that they are behaving in a certain manner which is not at all expected of them, which is not befitting the person who could be studying Gita? So that seems to be two parallel lives. And this is something which is very important, that you need to revisit all these different hurts and guilt which are not belonging to your present but belonging to the past. And the past has to be brought alive and it has to be dealt with and it has to be re-understood. You have to bring in everything that is staying, lying dormant, but it is like a dragon which keeps coming out at times without your even knowing about it, and sometimes with so much force that it renders you helpless. So the more you are aware of this unconscious, the more you don't ignore it, the more you bring it into your understanding of now, and the more you re-understand it based on your present understanding of the things, in the sense that if you are feeling guilty about doing certain things which are inappropriate, you can say that how I felt at that given point in time was according to the order. At that given point in time, I only understood that and I could not have done any better. But now I'm equipped with some better understanding in light of which I can change now. But I have to bring that past and I have to own it and I have to process it with the understanding of Ishvara as the order which made me feel like that and do actions like that. Also, with reference to my hurt, it is the same thing. I have to acknowledge that hurt, and that is in place, that is in order. But when people behaved in a certain manner which hurt me, their behavior was also conditioned by their understanding, and that understanding at that given point in time was also in order. I resolve my accounts with everyone in understanding the order. The order which makes everything what it is. Neither I deny the past that I have been carrying with me. I look at it, but I re-understand it with the vision of Ishvara and the order. And then I become free from this baggage of the past. I unload all the burden and then I become the person who's always connected to Ishvara and always alive to the order and very proactive in my life. And this is what it means when I understand all that is here is Ishvara and bringing that into my life. Matkarma krut matparamaha matbhakta sanga varjitaha nirvaira sarva bhuteshu yasamameti pandava.